We saw the Iron Giant, so hit it, Logan.
It's X After Hours Podcast with Mariah and Ty.
Your weekly download of X92.9's X Afternoons extracurricular activities. Enjoy.
This week on X After Hours.
Get your holiday shopping on at Old Navy.
Who the hell would name their kid Hogarth? It's like a social suicide death sentence for kids trying to make friends.
What if a gun had a soul and didn't want to be a gun? Interesting.
Oh my God, this little guy, he just like leaked out goo.
We did it, episode 41.
Or should we just start saying that we did it every...
We did it!
We did it! We've made it another week.
The countdown to 50 is on. This is a Earl Grey
shit
beer.
It was the last one at the liquor store, Ty.
My silk pants.
Oh, it's Earl's Ale, pale ale with Earl Grey tea. It's a strong beer, 6%.
Smells amazing.
From Born Brewing Co., created right here in Calgary. I love Earl Grey tea. It's Captain Picard's favorite, so.
Oh, this is delightful. I love how, like, beautiful the can is. That was my favorite thing about this.
It says it pairs well with brunch and besties.
That does taste like Earl Grey. I like that.
Yeah, it's good.
It is with Born notes Brewing. Of Simcoe, bergamot, vanilla, and tea.
Fantastic. Fantastic stuff. We did see the Iron Giant, but we'll get into that in the B block with our movie book club review.
Well, I thought that, you know, since we did kind of like a Halloween episode, I'm not saying this is the official start to it because we still have Remembrance Day, but if you haven't noticed, Christmas ads are here and they are front and center. Everything you do, you see, it's happening. So it is kind of like the unofficial start to the holiday season. And if you don't celebrate Christmas, I'm sure you're still not immune to the commercialism that is Christmas and it's shoved in your face everywhere.
Do they still say Christmas on those ads?
Lots of them do.
I thought they go like, get your holiday shopping on at Old Navy. True.
Yeah. I think that might just be Old Navy. I did see a Canadian Tire that was like, it's your Christmas shop. So, I mean, it's for...
They're trying to commercialize to all the cultures.
Yeah.
All of it.
Yes. But I will say, I don't hate it. You know?
Love Christmas.
Oh, God.
You love the holidays.
I love it. It makes me feel great.
I feel like Mariah doesn't enjoy any of fall because the whole time she spends it dreading winter.
Yes.
And then winter gets here and she's like, oh, Christmas! Let's go.
No, that's not true. I like Halloween.
You like the one day.
No, I like the decor and the baking and the scent.
But we're sitting there in the studio and you're going like, God, this is depressing. The leaves are falling.
It's the anticipation of summer leaving. Summer is my season. Ty's dying. Summer
is my season. I'm a fall-time boy.
Yeah. I don't know. I like being outside with warm air.
I'd say summer only beats spring for me.
Oh, okay.
I like fall and winter.
Okay.
I think if we live here, like, you have to learn to like winter.
Oh, I do. I don't hate winter by any means.
What's your seasonal rankings then?
Oh, that's challenging.
Mine goes fall, winter, summer, spring.
Summer number one. I would almost put winter at number two because of Christmas.
It's a big booster for you.
Number three would be fall. Number four is spring because spring in Alberta is garbage and shitty.
So gross.
It's not even spring. It's bullshit. It's like, hey, here's a May-long weekend snowfall for you. Have fun. Enjoy. Yeah, I don't like it. But I will say, though, it's been the start to the holiday season. Our boss has been like, take those vacation days.
Take those vacays.
Yeah, and you're kind of doing something unique. You think you want to go away? Not even to somewhere hot. You're like, I'm ready to go
anywhere.
To Drumheller for winter.
I not have to deal with the traditional Christmas.
Why?
Because I did it once with my parents where we went to Vegas and I had a great time.
Mm.
It was still Christmas.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Super fun.
Christmas doesn't have, it's but just about spending time with family. But you're not spending time with any family.
I spent time with my girlfriend and we might bring our dog. We might go somewhere with our dog. So.
Oh.
Wouldn't you say your dogs are your family? Wouldn't you feel bad ditching them on Christmas?
I would.
That's the only thing. Like, if it wasn't that holiday, I'd be like, put him in a kennel.
But you know what? Actually, now that you said you're flying, you could probably fly with him because he's like a small rodent size. You can do that with small dogs.
He's a cute Boy. He's like, a cute little prince. He's not a small rodent.
He looks like a meerkat. Smaller, though.
He's a cute little prince.
Sure.
Chonky meerkat.
Yeah, like, I don't think I could bring my dogs on a flight.
No, but are they going to come with you wherever you go for Christmas?
Yeah.
See, exactly. You don't want to leave them behind.
I'm going for like 2 weeks. If I was going somewhere over the holidays for 4 days, I'd be like, have fun, boys.
I don't think you could do it.
I'm leaving them like 3 times this month. I'm
just saying. But it's not on Christmas morning.
Well, that's where it really comes down to. I thought you were just saying
no. You
didn't trust anybody to look after
him. Last year I went up to him and I said, Santa Paws is here. Mm. He came. Brought you some gifts. He had no fucking clue what's going on. He doesn't give
it's
a shit.
More for
it's like
you.
Sweet, squeaky toy.
100%.
Wow, so that's the troubles, hey? Where are your top destinations you want to go to for your non-Christmas holiday?
Well, Drumheller, obviously.
Sure. Are you fucking kidding me? Come on.
I don't know. We're looking around. Everything's so expensive. I wanted to go to Vegas. But
if you go to Drumheller
I'm not actually going to Drumheller. I was just making a joke. I want to go to Vegas, but I don't want to bring a little dog to Las Vegas, a rescue dog who stressed the shit out all the time.
I think it would be more irresponsible to bring him with you.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm not bringing him to Vegas. He'd have an awful time.
But where
Vegas
are you going to bring him, here? Though?
I don't know. I'm going to figure that out, you guys.
So it's only it's actually just a trip for Dwight. It's not for you guys. It's for the dog.
Exactly. I got to take him somewhere where he can relax.
It's tough, though, because if you want to take the dog, or like you want to go on a vacation, you also have to factor in the cost of having the dog somewhere. That's what we're running into. Like, I'm going away with my dad in December, and we're running into the same issue. It's like, add $1,000 to whatever it is.
Why is it $1,000?
Because
big dogs.
We're going for a while, and big dogs. It's like $80 a day or something, plus like.
For to board him?
Have him stay with somebody.
Yeah.
Mariah will take him.
Max and Arthur would...
They would love each other. They would be best pals.
No, they would wrestle the whole time, and you'd be like, these fucking dogs.
it's my life. But I don't know. I mean, it is hard. Dogs are like your second kids. But, I mean, Sam, you're obviously going away, you said, for the holidays?
Hell yeah. I'm going to Vegas.
Oh, are you actually? What the fuck? Yeah. You guys are all going
to
Vegas?
Are you going to Chris, like, Christmas time?
Nah, 2 weeks before.
I want to go during.
What are you guys? Are you guys watching sporting events?
Of course. Why would I book a trip to Vegas for anything else?
His dad almost called him sports, but then he went with Sam. He was like, it's either Sports Phelps or Sam Phelps.
That would be so funny.
Yeah.
So what are you guys doing? Who are you seeing?
We're going to see a football game at the new, is it a Legion?
The Las Vegas Raiders.
Yeah. That thing looks crazy. It looks
is that where the Raiders are now?
Yeah.
Because I was confused. Mr. Bunce is going to Vegas in 2 weeks, and he's like, we're going to see a Raiders game. I was like, in Vegas?
You should see if the NBA play-in tournament is having the finals then.
We miss it by 2 days.
What? Just extend it.
No, it's 2 days earlier.
Just go early then.
Yeah. So you're going, you're watching some sports. Just you and your dad?
And
that's
Flames.
Cute.
Nice. And his girlfriend and my brother. It's a big old family trip.
Big Very fam fun. Jam.
Yeah.
Nice.
So.
Wow.
It's going to be fun. You should do Vegas, Ty.
I want to. I did it before. It was awesome. It was great.
There's some places I would like to go, during the holidays.
Vegas rocks during Christmas. You love decor.
Yeah.
You love music. You love the shops.
When I went
picture that, but you can walk around with a beer in your hand and gamble whenever you want.
I love it. Went to the first time, I've been to Hawaii twice. That's the only very far places I've traveled. But when I first went, I was in high school, over 10 years ago, and we went around Christmas time, and it is amazing what they do for Christmas there. Oh my God.
Yeah,
it's
all
so
those
different.
Touristy places rock it.
Well, it's just cool to see, how different people do it, right? But
and then that's what I want to do, but we'll see. We'll probably end up being in Canmore, and I'll be like, well.
That's where you're going to Canmore?
That's
kind of
nice,
Canmore?
Though.
I wouldn't mind it, but I would way rather go to Vegas.
You know Canmore?
Or take my girlfriend there. She's never been. She doesn't like to gamble.
Oh,
so.
There's more, but that's
I know,
people,
but that's exactly what would be fun about it. I'm
she
not a big
gambler.
She would
love the shows. She used to be a dancer. You should go take her to, a circus show.
I am the one member of my family who doesn't gamble, and I still want to go back and take her.
Vegas is, the shopping, the shows, the food, the, the music. It's you can see so much.
The food's insane.
The rippers.
Single,
the Rippers.
Hey, man who would like to order chicken and waffles. How does 12 pounds of it sound?
Oh
it's like,
my
that's
God.
Too much.
But it's just I just
that's
can't get over,
it's crazy.
I was even trying to tell, Mr. Bunce, to go walk in like all the hotel lobbies because
it's wild.
Yeah, it's crazy to see like these different hotels, and you don't even think that's like anything to do, but it is. It's like mental.
You've been to Vegas before?
First time.
Ooh.
I like Fremont Street more than the Strip. The Strip's very cool.
Yeah.
But that's so much ground to cover.
I didn't have enough time to go there when I went. I've heard it's cool.
Oh, yeah. Old Vegas, they have the roof over you, Sam.
Yeah.
It's like Stephen Ave.
Yeah.
But there's a roof over you, and it's like projecting things at you all the time. And all these old, like historic casinos are there.
That's a good idea for me because I'm going to try and stay out of the sun as much as possible.
Well, that's right. You are allergic to the sun, boy. Yeah,
that's right.
A little pale baby.
Little pale baby.
Little pale baby who will sit in the sun for sports, though.
Holy
so it's going to be fun.
Shit.
The fans are there at the same time.
Those holiday ads, though.
We should get back to that.
Okay, but for real, though, why I wanted to talk about the holiday ads, or are we not? I see you looking at the clock, so.
I'm just keeping us to time. I know we got a big movie of Iron Giant to talk to, but let's hear it.
I was just going to say that the holiday ads are probably most what gets me into the spirit. Like,
you cried during the commercials?
Yeah, but I like shit on consumerism, but I'm like, oh man, this Canadian Tire commercial like got me.
What are you getting your nephew?
God, I know that's really hard.
Tickle Me Elmo.
Well,
is that still a hot toy?
I think he's turning two like right before Christmas, right? He's a December baby. So on December 7th.
Lot of monster gifts.
Huge. Paw I've been Patrol. Trying to collect him like giant zoo animal stuffies.
Aww.
So last year I got him a very tall giraffe, like probably like the same size as that cutout. But now he's doing a little bit more active things. So I wanted to get him like a child-friendly GT racer. And Mr. Bunn said that's too intense.
A child-friendly treadmill. I was like, good.
Get him in the gym early.
Yeah, get him lifting. No, I don't know. Because our nephews are around the same. They're around the same age. And I don't know. What did you get, Emery? Are you thinking about getting him something for Christmas?
Oh, just give him Spider-Man shit or Batman. They love it. Like, it doesn't matter. And Spider-Man. Ugh. Or Batman's really big with them. They love Batman and Spider-Man. Those are the two. And the Hulk.
It's actually funny. My
Big green guy. What's not to like?
My nephew's been obsessed with the birds, peacocks, because he went and saw them at the zoo.
Mm.
And he's been obsessed about like large, like cool animals. So I'm like, I don't know.
Take him to a movie.
You think he'd like that?
I took my niece to a movie once for her birthday.
Long? He's only two.
Yeah, that's like when I took my niece to like her first movie. It was awesome. We went to Paw Patrol.
Do you think she's gonna remember it?
The Mighty movie?
No, I think I saw the first one. Was that the first one?
There's another one that just
came out. Took my niece to her first movie with my brother and
that's a good idea.
My sister-in-law, and like, let me tell you, that Paw Patrol movie, so good.
Wow.
Yeah, I loved it. I would love if you sat through one of those Paw Patrol movies.
Forget the Iron Giant. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd love if you did that.
Yeah.
Roll that in. Let's go.
It's X After Hours with Mariah and Ty.
It's like X Afternoons, but in podcast form.
All right, we saw The Iron Giant. Everyone watched it. Everyone did their homework, which is insane for this podcast. Sam watched it twice.
You watched it twice. You love watching movies more than once, like in
a row. I do like that, though. I used to do that.
Yeah. I also have a bit of a hyperactive brain, so sometimes if I don't have multiple watches, I'm like, wait, what happened?
You didn't retain.
The first time you watched it, you were playing Fortnite in the background. You're like, wait a second, maybe I should pay attention.
That's what it is.
That's the Sam Phelps generation. He's like, I had three different video games going. Yeah.
I have some Iron Giant facts.
Oh, okay. We want to do the. We want to do trivia. The facts.
Let's do the trivia and then we'll get into it because, like, I don't know what else to do the trivia. So it was Brad Bird. It was his directorial debut. Do you recognize the name Brad Bird?
When I was reading about this, he's done some other really like.
He made The Incredibles.
Yes.
This was his directorial debut. Now, this is the fact that Logan, our producer, said.
Sounded silly.
It is, but I think it's got a heartfelt message. Even Logan admitted that. Brad Bird was in part inspired to make this movie as a memorial to his sister Susan, who died at the hands of her estranged husband by gun violence. His pitch was, what if a gun had a soul and didn't want to be a gun? Interesting. Excluding the yells and groans, the Iron Giant only says a total of 53 words. And then Vin Diesel would also be cast as Groot in Guardians of the Galaxy.
I was going to say, mm-hmm. Vin Diesel loves getting cast to do like very little amount of work.
But I don't
think
he would. Groot would have never lived if the Iron Giant didn't exist first.
I am Groot.
Yeah, that's right.
That's it.
Although the film received high praise from critics, it was deemed a box office failure, grossing only $23 million after a reported $70 million budget. I mean, that animation is still crisp today.
But, like...
That's 1999. Just wait. The low earnings were partly due to the fact that the film had its nationwide debut on the same day as The Sixth Sense.
I would do it.
I see dead people. That movie's awesome. Great film.
Yeah. Okay, you have more facts you want to go through?
The animators were concerned with the giant... and his believability, saying the word Superman with its inflexible machine mouth. There was actual applause during the dailies, which is when they like show the footage to people after it's done, when they perfected how to achieve this. And I'm like, well, it's a robot. It probably just has a speaker in it. Why does it matter how his lips look?
Well, I think they're thinking about details that people would scrutinize, critics of the film. No, there's a point in the movie where he gets his jaw knocked off.
I know.
And it comes back to him. So they obviously put that in there to make note of it. Like,
and the Signature Edition has a bunch of cutscenes even explaining the giant's origins in space. Did anyone watch the Signature Edition?
Is that on Crave?
It's not on Crave, but there's extra scenes, and they've actually, there's a scene, I believe, as well, where they have a Walt Disney movie in it, which they couldn't get the rights to at the time.
Oh,
I didn't include that fact in because I was like, it's such a small detail. Who gives a shit? But
yeah. Netflix only had the standard edition.
So. Wait, it was on Netflix for you?
Yeah.
What?
It was on Netflix for all of us.
No.
Well, yeah, we were crazy.
It's leaving soon, but.
Oh, I didn't think that two streaming services could have the same.
They can.
Interesting.
I've seen the Bob's Burgers movie on Crave and on Disney Plus.
Wow.
Good movie.
Didn't like that movie.
All right. Well.
Loved Iron Giant.
They be fighting words.
Do we want to do like a light synopsis of the film for people who haven't really watched it?
Well, Sam, yeah, it was your first time seeing the movie.
Mm-hmm. It was. And
did you take notes at all, or did you just watch it twice?
I just watched it twice.
He took mental notes.
Yeah. Shooter McGavin.
Yeah,
the shooter. He's McDonald.
He's a dick. Fuck
he plays
that
the
guy.
Character freaking well, though.
Fuck that
right?
guy. That was my biggest takeaway.
Is that
from
Hanley?
The film.
Was that his name?
It should
say in the synopsis. We brought a synopsis.
Kent Mansley.
That scene where like he comes to the door and he's like Kent Mansley, U.S. government, and then the kid just shoves it in his face. Oh. Perfect.
This is Cold War era, which when I rewatched this at first, in the beginning, there was a bunch of scenes that I don't ever remember picking up on, like where Hogarth is in school and the teacher's playing a video on how to take proper bomb shelter coverage.
Yeah, nuclear holocaust.
Yeah. And I was like, whoa, but you can just tell like the satire is insane. Like one of the things that I read about in this article to talk about like the underlining meanings was the advent paranoia of Americans always worried about an outside war threat. And in worrying about this outside war threat from other countries, they create mass paranoia within their own population, which adds and aids to gun violence from people having all these firearms and weaponry. And I just thought, man, this is such a heavy, interesting topic to cover that is also basically marketed towards children in this novel.
And you know what's crazy? That whole concept still happens today.
Oh, yeah.
In the US, there's always, like, a person you need to be afraid of.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, but no, just live your goddamn life, guys.
Well, I think that I don't have the exact stats, but that's, like, a known thing that gun violence within America with other citizens, American citizens, is way higher than any other outside threat that has ever come in. But I don't know. Overall, when I was reading, like, and just watching the film, I was like, man. So many small parts of this that I don't remember that are
classic.
Just so great.
It's one of those movies for adults, so you can watch it. But the film opened up with the Iron Giant kind of like falling down eventually, right? Could we get a clip of that, Sam?
Of course.
Maybe just him meeting the Iron Giant, for all I care.
Thank you.
Because the kid's name is Hogarth. Weird effing name.
Yeah, is there a meaning behind
that?
No,
they were just like, you know, it's the 50s. Fuck it. Name the kid Hogarth.
But they bring that up in the show, though. There is a point where Mansley says to his superior on the phone, he's like, yeah, there's this kid Hogarth, and who the hell would name their kid Hogarth? It's like a social suicide death sentence for kids trying to make friends. And I was sure. Like, wow, okay. But I don't know. Overall, I was just like, this is such a damn good movie. I cried so
by
much.
The way, also, seeing Hogarth at the end of the movie play with all his buddies.
Yeah.
After everything happened, because you got the confidence from being friends with the giant.
Yeah.
Aw.
Yeah.
It was, like, it's so heartwarming. And like the feeling, like when the guy says to like fire off the missile, and then
Mansley,
yeah, and the giant goes and just like blows. Oh,
it's a super
man. I will get so emotional. I was like so worked up. I was like, it was, oh,
you were done in by it, but what did you think of Sexy Dean?
Oh my God.
Mariah thought this cartoon man was sexy, voiced by Harry Connick Jr.
Because he is. He's like this.
Soul patch, too.
He's a very, very different entity. You can tell like an early style characteristic of what you would see coming into the 60s, right, of this person who is moving away from this, you know, 9-to-5 traditional American, like, workforce man.
He's an outsider.
Driving his
motorcycle in the snow.
He's got the turtleneck on with the Ray-Bans, and he's all cool, and he's, like, into music. He's got non-clean-shaven face, and I'm like, yeah, he's so into it.
That's your Lola Bunny.
So, oh,
I was
going to
say,
yeah.
Or Jessica Rabbit.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
But I love how Hogarth's mom ends up with him after, and in the scene where Mansley.
What do you mean? It was so obvious.
Oh, I know, but I'm just saying.
Did you think she was going to go with Mansley?
No, but I'm just saying it's funny how Mansley, there's a small part where he comes into the home initially to question this kid, mm-hmm. and he kind of checks out the mom, right? And she couldn't be bothered, and then it's just so funny that she goes for the person that everybody in that town probably doesn't like, right? He's kind of like an outcast.
What do you mean?
That
guy's a smooth criminal.
She doesn't,
oh.
Sure. She doesn't like the military man.
The mom was voiced by Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah.
She doesn't like the military man?
No, she
wasn't
doesn't.
Her dad, wasn't Hogarth's dad a fighter pilot?
I think she just didn't like Mansley because he was this neurotic psycho.
Probably blames the military for the dad's
yes.
death. That's probably it.
Yes.
Psychoanalyzing the characters here.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure. Sam, you watched it twice. That's what you were doing.
Yeah.
What did you think of the scene where they put the X-lax in the guy's
the
drink
milkshake?
And he gets
that was
the shits.
So funny.
And he's like, that's, what is this here new recipe you got?
That's, yeah. When I watch Home Alone, it's like almost like a similar gag to that, where it's like so easy to write, but it just works for that
yeah.
scene. It was perfect.
And what do you guys think about the animation from 1999?
Oh my God, it is magical. There needs to be more of that brought in.
When was the last time you actually sat down and watched one of those movies?
An
that
animated
isn't
movie?
Like, that movies? Isn't like The Lion King or a classic.
Oh, you mean like a, okay.
An early Sam birth year movie.
I watched Anastasia not that long ago, and that guy is the same gentleman who did Land Before Time and The Secret of Nim. Super known for doing like really dark kind of, you know, animation, mm-hmm. but.
My absolute favorite movie, and I was talking with my dad a little bit about this yesterday, Treasure Planet.
Oh, so good.
Also a box office flop.
I think I remember
amazing.
Treasure Planet. I would take the Iron Giant.
Oh. Isn't Matt Damon in
no,
Treasure Planet?
No, Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
Oh, sorry. Okay, hold on. I'm thinking of... One sec.
Yeah.
And JGL.
Also
was,
super hot.
So this
love
thing
Justin
launched
Gordon
on the same weekend as like a Harry Potter movie. And they're like, why did it tank? It's like, well, yeah, it launched the same weekend as Harry Potter.
So crazy.
But I just like love when you get those unique tales through animation that work. The one thing with like the art design, you don't see a lot of like 2D hand-drawn stuff, style animation
that's
anymore.
That's like the Princess and the Frog.
Yeah,
yes.
Everything nowadays has that like weird 3D effect to it.
Well, it's different.
I don't like it as much.
They had some CG in this, I think, some CGI.
But it still looks like hand-drawn animation.
Nice.
Do you guys know the movie Fern Gully? Did you watch that?
Yes. Yes, I did.
It's another like dark animation of a big message of massive conglomerates. Like it has a very dark undertone to it, which I was like, we need more movies like that, you know?
Those dark undertones.
Ah, gets me.
So the movie is Cold War. Iron Giant comes. Kid befriends it. Correct me if I'm wrong. Then the army comes. Kid tries to distract the army from noticing the giant. Giant seems like a pretty chill dude. One point, the kid pulls a toy gun on the Iron Giant. The Iron Giant's like, I'm going to kill you.
Well, okay.
Pretty much. The Iron Giant's like, I'm going to kill you right now. And then somehow misses. And then Dean comes, saves the kid. The kid tells the giant he's not a gun.
He has a choice.
He's a choice. God damn it. And the giant says he wants to be Superman. Because Warner Brothers owns this picture, god damn it. And it's true, though. They do. They own Superman.
Well, yeah.
They did get Disney in it, eventually, in the Signature Edition. And then Mansley brings the army in. Dean hides it. I loved when Dean hid the giant.
Yeah, so smooth.
That was so funny.
This is my art project.
Yeah, that was well considered. Oh, I think hold on. You missed a critical part, not to backtrack.
We covered the diarrhea.
Okay, what? Oh, yeah. No, but I meant like the part where Hogarth first discovers him and he's entangled in the high power electricity, like the wires, the power wires.
Yes.
And he first connects with him and he understands that he is a being that can learn and that he can communicate with, and he shows him like death and life.
He brings
him
the little panel.
Yes.
To save him. It was
yes.
so sweet.
Oh my God. And I was just like, I was just melted when he got him out of all the wirings and he showed him that he can communicate. But yeah, basically fast forward back to the part where Ty was, where Mansley eventually figures out that he can get the army to go and do some recon on this weaponry that they keep on figuring is either Russian or what is that? What is that word that they keep on referencing that is real? That is another threat that was a threat in the Cold War. What the hell was it? They kept on calling it Sputnik. They kept on being like, Sputnik.
Oh, Sputnik. You can see Sputnik in the movie there.
Yeah.
So it's a little Easter egg.
Yeah. And so eventually they obviously like the town turns on this giant and it becomes not correct on if it's a threat or not. And I think Mansley just has this power hungry. He's like the perfect example of a guy who is a gun nut, power hungry.
Stress boy.
Yeah.
And then he calls in the heavies. They come back. They call in a bomb. The Iron Giant, after saving two children, is like, well, I am good. I'm going to save the day. And they said, if you watch closely, when he goes to save the day and say he's Superman, the general of the army does a salute.
Really?
In the sky.
Didn't pick up on that.
Yeah, a little Easter egg for you. And then when I watched it, I did notice that. And I was like, oh, cool. I didn't notice that when I was a kid because I was
watching the main point. Yeah.
And then at the end of the movie, we see the statue where the Iron Giant's immortalized in. Dean and Hogarth's mom. And then
she's like, this is your best work yet, honey, because he created the statue.
Yeah, and then they go and all go to bed. Hogarth wakes up. He gets a box from the military. It's a screw.
It
was like the little screw from
bolt.
The side of his head.
Yeah.
And then it wants to leave his house because the Iron Giant can repair itself. And then it flashes us to, like, Iceland or Antarctica.
I think it's Iceland.
Iron Giant's coming back to life. And then he would go on to star in Ready Player One and Space Jam 2.
Fuck Space Jam 2. Fuck Space Jam 2.
He was in Ready Player One, though.
Do you think they would ever make a second Iron Giant?
It's based off the book The Iron Man.
Yes.
And there is a sequel book called The Iron Lady or Iron Woman.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Oh. You're diving a little deeper into the world of Mariah and Ty with the X After Hours podcast.
All right, we're back, and now it's time for Mariah and Ty's
Hall of Fame.
Mariah and Ty's Hall of Fame.
I believe this week's winner was Rando Nodding.
Oh, crazy. The weird
app. I haven't gone Rando Nodding since because you have to pay extra to go a little longer. If everyone wants to get in touch with the paranormal around Christmas time, get visited by three ghosts.
Spooky.
Maybe use Rando Nodding.
The plot of Scrooged.
Oh my god, this little guy, he just like leaked out goo.
Gross, don't touch that thing anymore. Mariah's touching the set. If you're watching the video on Spotify or YouTube, she threw it at me. Ew, it's wet as fuck. What the fuck is this? Nastiest shit. It's just like a little demon man. Anyways, now it's time for Mariah and Ty's review of the week.
It's time for Mariah and Ty's review of the week.
Oh, man. All right. I think overall, together as a group, we are going to review our movie study that we did, The
Iron Giant.
I don't know the fuck he says it. Okay.
Do you want to go first?
Oh, I give this movie like a 12 out of 10. I loved it. I think it's amazing. I think it has a great message. The animation is beautiful. The acting is great. Nobody talks about how great that little man was who did the voice acting, the child who voiced Hogarth. Yeah. Fabulous.
What are you going to pick to nominate in the poll, like from the movie?
Oh, I would like to...
Dean Soulpatch?
Oh, God. I would like to nominate the scene where the Iron Giant does the cannonball into the lake.
That's a great fucking scene.
And it's like, and then Dean's just like swept away. And that guy's like, hey, you know you're in the middle of the road? He's like, huh? So? What happened?
I'm going to give the Iron Giant 10 popcorns out of 10. It was very realistic, nicely well done, very well animated. And I'm going to give the name Hogarth into the Hall of Fame to be voted on.
That's a hurting name, by the
way. Where's more of the Hogarths out there?
That'd be a great dog name.
Sam, your review of The Iron Giant.
I'd also give it 10 out of 10. I thought it was incredible. The one thing I noticed, like, going through it, how similar it is to Lilo and Stitch.
Oh.
Well, Lilo and Stitch came out after.
Oh, I know, but it's just, like, the themes in the movie and, like, the general direction of the movie, very similar to Lilo and Stitch.
Mm,
I like it because I like Lilo and Stitch and I like The Iron Giant, but a lot of similarity there. And if I could nominate anything for the Hall of Fame, Hogarth's mom.
Oh, wow. She's good looking.
Also, it's Jennifer Aniston. Come on. Like,
woo! Yeah, I liked it.
What'd you guys think of the beers?
They're good. I like them. I agree with what producer Logan in the back there said about them being like a little bit too big. Like, they're acquired taste, so a little bit of a smaller... can, but I think they're beautiful. They're nice can, good flavor. Yeah.
I thought Born Brewing knocked it out. I give it 10 popcorns out of 10 as well. And
I'll give it a 10 out of 10.
Sam, what do you give it?
Did you know it contains barley and wheat?
Had a hunch.
Yeah. Mm.
What do you give it?
The can points that out. I'd give it like a solid like 8 out of 10. I wish it almost had a little bit more Earl Grey taste to it.
Mm.
It still
tastes
kind of beery. Like
it's
a very pale ale drink.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
I think it's one of my more enjoyable pale ales I've had.
Yeah.
Before we get out of here, we should say if you watched The Iron Giant and you have thoughts and feedback or maybe something we missed, email us at xafternoons@x929.ca. Is that correct?
Yeah.
That is it.
Or maybe you have like a new movie that we should do another movie study.
People are going to be like, A Bug's Life. Let's get to the candy corn
so
talk.
So good. Bug's Life is great.
What do you prefer, Bug's Life or Ants?
Oh, Ants was underrated, but Bug's Life for real. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wow.
I'm a Pixar bitch, so yeah, Bug's Life.
All right, well, we're out of here. Peace out. Bye.
Peace out.
Peace out. A-Town down.
Burp, 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 burp. Sorry.
That's the out.
You've been listening to X After Hours Podcast with Mariah and Ty.
You want more? Then tune into X Afternoons with these two live on Calgary's alternative X92.9 Monday through Friday, 2 to 7 p.m. Mountain Time at x92.9.ca.
And don't forget to subscribe to this podcast and have the new episode of X After Hours downloaded weekly to whatever device you use.
You there, boy on the street.
Me, sir?
Yes, you. What day is it today?
Why, it's Stranger Things Day, sir.
Stranger Things Day? Then there's still time. Boy on the street, is that giant turkey still available? You know, the one on the corner shop window on First Street? I want you to take this money and go buy it and bring it to Tiny Tim's house.
That's not enough money, sir! The price of inflation is too high!
God damn it! I shouldn't have spent all my money on that Netflix subscription!
Ty, what the f*** are you doing? Get inside!